Hi, I'm Aaron with Seattle Piano Company, and today I am standing with one of our newly imported Kawai upright pianos. As you can see, it's totally taken apart. It's receiving some service right now, and we wanted to go over some of the service that happens after these pianos come in. So when a piano is brand new and it's delivered to the dealer, fresh out of the crate, it still needs some work. As much as I love Yamaha and Kawai and I kind of triumph those brands here on at my store and on this channel, at the end of the day, they're still factories. They're coming out of factories with assembly line type work. So there's some refinement that's kind of left up to the dealer to perform once the piano arrives. So this piano is not a new piano, but it still needs some work. In Japan, when they work over these pianos, I mean, the finish is stunning. I mean, they do a ton of work to the finish. They buff it out, they wet sand, they re-spray if needed. When you look on the inside, like the tuning pins, the strings, the just like even like underneath the keys, like all this stuff is so clean. They do such an amazing job reconditioning these instruments, but part of that service or part of what they do is replacing the felts inside of the key. And so the felts inside of the key are actually a wearable part. The keys sit in a key frame, which consists of metal pins. And those metal pins are what kind of guides the key up and down straight. So over the years, the felt, which is the barrier between the wood and the metal pin, that felt kind of wears out and you get this like slop in the key. It'll feel kind of loose. So by replacing these felts, we kind of eliminate that. But when you rebush a key or a set of keys, you want it to fit ever so slightly snugly. And in the factory, in Yamaha, Kawai, Steinway, in the factory, they make them slightly snug, but what that can sometimes do is that can translate to a sluggish key or a heavy key. So in this instance, this is not a new piano, but we have some new piano parts. And so we're gonna have to kind of go through this sort of as if it were a brand new Kawai piano, go through it and make it play as best as it could be. So in this service, we're gonna go through and we're going to ease the keys. And by easing it, we're gonna make the opening in these felts just slightly larger. We have a specialized tool that we're gonna use to iron the felts and open it up a little bit. So our tool here is a soldering iron that has a modified tip to hold a piece that is going to go in the key and iron out the felt. All right, so we're just gonna move down the line here. The key is to move relatively quickly. If the iron is too hot or if you leave it in there for too long, you can singe the felt. I have definitely singed a few felts in my day and had to replace them, which is not fun. As I'm going through here, some of these feel a little bit tighter than others, and the ones that are feeling a little bit tighter are the ones that would maybe cause a little bit of that sluggishness in the key or a little bit heavier of a feel. Yeah, like that one was super tight. So we got the felt all ironed out and the keys back in the piano. The test to see if the tolerances are correct and the felt and the pins is you lift up on the keys and they should be falling on their own weight. If they kind of get stuck as you lift them up, there's some more adjusting and some more easing to do. So the keyboard, as far as the mechanics go in a piano, I mean, it's really the foundation of the piano, and if the keys have too much tension in them or if they're not set at the correct height, the hammers and the action can't do their job. So it's not gonna sound right, it's not gonna play right, a lot of weird stuff happens. So we spend a lot of time on keyboards here, some really important work, and it gets overlooked a lot. So I hope this was somewhat informative for you guys. The BS-30 is gonna go back together right now. It was tuned a little bit earlier today, so it's ready for sale. If you have any questions, go ahead and give me a call or shoot me an email. Thanks a lot.